Across China, there are areas of saline and alkaline land amounting to 100 million hectares, roughly the size of Egypt, where no crops can grow. The infertile soil has undermined rural economies and devastated farmers' livelihoods. However, in the east coast city of Qingdao, the seeds of hope are being sown. A crop called saltwater rice is promising to reclaim the barren land. To find out more, tune in this Sunday to Rediscovering China. It would seem natural to assume that China's vast territory contains more than enough fertile land to feed even the world's largest population. But the truth is that just 14% of China is arable. To make matters worse, much of the uncultivated land has been deemed too saline or alkaline for crops ever to grow. Nowhere is the problem felt more acutely than in the countryside of coastal Qingdao. So, why is saline alkali soil bad for crops? Well, salt reduces a plant's ability to absorb water through its roots, while high alkalinity causes the soil to become so dense that it effectively suffocates the plant. With only such infertile land to work on, farmers have little alternative other than to leave home in search of alternative sources of income. Wangling Village is an example of how saline alkali soil can devastate livelihoods.
There are some 1,000 households here, most of whom who own a bit of land. However, most of the villagers here are not growing any crops, as a lot of them have all gone out to work in the town where money is easier to be made.
Few working age adults are now seen in the village. The majority have left because they were simply unable to earn a living off the land. Only the elderly and the very young remain. Wangling is apparently in a state of irreversible decline, except that an almost miraculous transformation seems to be underway.
But these are actually growing pretty well, aren't they? You probably wouldn't believe me, but for many decades this entire area was a wasteland where traditional crops just didn't grow. And in 2018, this entire formerly barren area was transformed into the rice paddies that you see today. And that's because planted here are species of saltwater rice that have been specially cultivated to be tolerant of the saline alkali soil found here.
Also known as seawater rice, the crop's capable of growing in water with a significantly higher than normal salt content. Ordinary rice cannot grow in water containing more than 0.3% salt. In comparison, the best performing strains of saltwater rice can grow in water with double that salinity. Better still, yields can be as much as twice the 4.5 tons per hectare, generally considered the break-even standard for farmers. All in all, saltwater rice is an exciting prospect for Wangling Village. Chinese scientists have been researching saltwater rice since the 1970s. However, they were never able to produce a strain with a high enough yield to be economically viable. That was until the Saline Alkali Tolerant Rice Research and Development Center in Qingdao entered the scene, a national institute founded in 2016. These plots are the source of several recent breakthroughs in saltwater rice development. Over 100 different varieties of experimental rice are growing here. The whole operation is overseen by academician Yuan Longping, known in China as the father of hybrid rice. He and his team have been researching saltwater rice since 2014, and in 2017, he was appointed as the research center's first director. Yuan Longping's saltwater rice research focuses on varieties that have high salt and alkali tolerance, which are crossbred with regular high-yield rice. The idea is that successful strains of saltwater rice can be produced that carry genes for both high tolerance and high yield. In addition to the traditional selective breeding techniques, his team have also boosted the efficiency of their work by using molecular markers to quickly identify and track desirable traits in their hybrids. A key member of the team is Li Jimin. Dr. Li spent over a decade working with molecular markers in the US. With his help, in 2018, the first batch of saltwater rice was planted in saline-alkali soil near Wanglin village. Local farmers were hired to plant and manage the crop. Having initially come for the pay, many soon realized the potential of what they were doing. Wei Tuiyu was among the first group of those hired.
Hey, Aunty, how are you? Busy, right? What is this? This is grass.
Grass?
Oh, just to treat it. Hey. Oh, you are every day to manage this big piece of land? Hey, yes. Oh, every day.
Quite
tiring. That you live near here, right?
是很近，我们主要住在前面。哦，就在前面啊。嗯。能一起过去看看吗？可以啊。好啊。哈哈哈。等您忙完。嗯。
Like most of the villagers, Wei Tuiyu owns a small plot of land. Before getting the saltwater rice job, she had little to do, other than spending her time alone, looking after the house, while her husband and son worked away from home in nearby cities.
他们也是欠了那么些上一辈了，也试验过，试验过了，种花小麦了，哎，看看有的也弄错了，错了又不下雨了，一天旱，都死了，他就连根儿都打不回来，种子都打不回来。Traditional
crops, if they manage to grow at all in saline alkali soil, produce a low yield, so there's no profit to be made. This means that saltwater rice must have a high yield in order to be economically viable. In 2018, the most productive strain of saltwater rice yielded 9.3 tons per hectare, twice as much as what researchers were expecting.
最低也得卖5块钱都就抢了吧，都卖不着吧。我觉得肯定卖不多，这个盐碱种出来的是大米肯定不吃。Even
if farmers can be persuaded to grow saltwater rice, can consumers be persuaded to eat it? To find out, I've come back to the R&D center for a taste test.
This is surprisingly good. You would have thought that, you know, hybrid rice, experimental rice, would have some particularly strange flavors. But this is quite similar to the kind of long grain that I'm used to.
feels quite fragrant, and it doesn't differ in taste to the rice I've tried before. I'm pleasantly surprised.
And no, it doesn't have the taste of seawater. As a researcher, Yu Meng spends her mornings trudging through waterlogged paddies to collect data on the experimental rice. It's tough physical work under the sun, followed by an afternoon of data analysis in the office. And though it may not sound like a dream job, Yu Meng had no hesitation in joining the R&D center after being impressed by their ambitious aims at a graduate job fair. Grandpa Yuan, as Yuan Longping is affectionately known, is someone who's used to achieving great things. His hybrid rice paddies have helped China more than triple its rice output since the 1970s. However, across the country, there are areas of saline and alkaline land amounting to 100 million hectares, roughly the size of Egypt, where no crops can grow. Even Yuan Longping's initial goal of transforming just a fifth of this area into saltwater rice paddies is still a very tall order. Critics point out, however, that watering such a vast area of land will require the construction of costly irrigation works. It's an expense that's hard to justify at a time when China no longer suffers from the food shortages that led to the hybrid rice research project's launch. Yet still today, food security remains a major issue for the Chinese government. China must feed almost a fifth of the world's population from just 7% of its arable land. The need for the country to be more self-reliant is pressing, given the potential for a global food crisis caused in part by salinization. Already, a billion hectares of arable land, an area the size of Europe, has been lost. The United States Department of Agriculture estimates that 10 million hectares more every year is becoming saline. Complicating the efforts to address the problem, worldwide and in China, is the multiple types of saline alkali soil.
See, this is a great visual representation of the many different kinds of saline alkali soils found here in China. For example, we're currently on the east coast here in Qingdao, but the soil here is very different to the kind of inland soil in the northeast of China, which again differs to the kind of soil on the other side of the country in the northwest. And many of these differences are caused by local weather conditions, different environmental conditions as well. And these come together to pose a set of challenges that must be overcome by scientists in order to create successful strains of saltwater rice.
China has five main kinds of saline alkali soil, each requiring a different approach from Yuan Longping and his team. In 2018, they branched out to Zhaoyuan County in northeast China's Heilongjiang province. Whereas seawater is the problem in Qingdao, in Zhaoyuan, the culprit is crude oil. That's because the county lies within China's largest oil field. The exposure to petroleum has resulted in Zhaoyuan soil having one of the highest levels of alkalinity in the country. What's more, for rice to survive here, it not only has to be tolerant of the excessive salt and alkali, but also capable of withstanding northeast China's bitterly cold climate. Rice is grown in parts of the northeast, despite the adverse natural conditions, and is considered among the best in China. But neither rice nor any other crop thrives in the Zhaoyuan area. The alkali in the soil damages the sensitive roots of the plants and forms membranes that suffocate them. The locals have tried cleansing the soil by flushing it with water, but the procedure is costly and ineffective. Many have given up and now raise livestock instead.
Pretty much feels like we're in the desert here. I mean, aside from, you know, a couple wild grasses and reeds, not much is growing in this saline alkali soil. In fact, this place is so heavily alkaline that it's more or less sodic soil, and when it rains, I mean, it just, the whole earth turns into this incredibly dense mud, this substance that just doesn't allow for any crops to thrive at all.
Rice requires plenty of water in order to grow, but that's not the issue here. The problem is, due to its high alkalinity, this soil doesn't drain. All this water simply sits on the surface, effectively drowning any crops that are planted. Traditionally, people here use this mud to make their roofs, because they never leak when it rains.
秋天的时候基本上才树植的时候，这个得不能得穿水鞋。你要是说那光脚的话进去的话，这个水污染很大，你这个脚都起一层疙瘩。这个偏移质值，像这种泡子，像这种泡子，像这个里头的，现在应该是8.5左右。普通作物那浇上的话，那基本上延缓生长，长不了。
2/3 of China's population eat rice as a staple food. Most of it is grown in the country's warmer, wetter south. In order to create a more resilient rice strain, Qingdao's R&D center uses cold light sources to simulate the harsh conditions of northeast China. It took many attempts before researchers finally produced a strain capable of surviving in Zhaoyuan's inhospitable soil and climate. However, there's a world of difference between lab-grown and field-proven rice. Charged with assessing the new strain is regional manager Zhou Li. To get better data, he wants to expand the area planted with the experimental rice. To this end, he's actively partnering with local farmers. One of those he's working with is Lan Guangfu.
Hey, Lan 总是吧? 哎，你好，你好，打扰您了哈。好，我先请您。哎，好好好，谢谢。
Lan Guangfu works for a company that manages 720 hectares of land here.
我的人就喜欢种地，小时候就开始种地。那个我小的时候，我爸爸那时候是就是山地的会计，完了然后那个，乍开始开发稻田的时候，整个浪都是我爸设计的。所以那时候呢，我就是对这方面挺感兴趣的。等到自己能开始干活了。
Mr. Lan tried planting the seeds of many different strains, but despite his plentiful experience in cultivating rice across northeast China, even he was stumped.
开发种植屡屡失败，得说那就是有时候赔的都不行了。你像13年嘛，我们种上之后基本上就是500来亩，能收的也就是。 七八十亩吧，那个15年嘛，我就种这门前这一块，公司说的，你看你能种，那你种吧这块，我就种了，这是事实，我投入正好是70万，到秋天收到的时候就卖了19600。The
years of failure put significant financial strain on the family, but Lan Guangfu persevered. To make ends meet, he started raising pigs, ducks, and fish. But he never gave up the search for the right seed. In 2018, he met regional manager Zhou Li, but was initially skeptical about his claims concerning saltwater rice. After all, buying seeds costs money, and Lan Guangfu was wary of failing yet again.
这个种子当时呢，定价呢，我们定价了，我们定价了的时候呢，他不相信，我们跟他签了一个合作议程。 你要是说的他亩产呢，他不要求高，他说亩产达到300公斤，就把那个种子款返还给我们。我们说的，你要是达不到300公斤，我们这个种子我们就白送给你。要达到300公斤往上，你再把种子款回购给我们。这个蓝总这回彻底服了。
From skeptic to true believer, at first, Lan Guangfu refused to tell his neighbors what he was growing, but now they often come to visit his plot of saltwater rice to admire the progress of his crop.
非常高兴，你看这个稻穗啊，没有一个瘪子啊，都非常诚实，上的非常好，磨灰这粒都硬粒的，磨灰第二都硬粒的。
我们计划把收完之后确准亩产量能产多少，完了做一下预算，能有多大盈利，完总公司就是想要投资，计划开个4-5千亩，现在试一年。看着今年这个经营方式和今年使用这个海水稻这个种子，我们好像很有信心，总公司也想同意往这上投资。
Their partnership benefits both Lan Guangfu and regional manager Zhou Li. Lan is finally starting to make money from the former barren land, while Zhou is able to obtain more data. He and his team regularly check up on the rice and send sample seeds back to headquarters in Qingdao, all the while teaching Lan Guangfu new techniques for cultivating his crop. Their success portends bigger and better things to come. Zhou Li tells me there are 40 to 50 more farmers like Lan Guangfu in the area who manage at least 700 hectares of land. He believes Lan's good example will persuade them to join the program and not only further the research into saltwater rice, but also contribute to economic development locally.
这一块来讲的话，这个海水稻就是研发成功了之后，我感觉能对赵源县这一块的话，就是农业直接产出能起很大作用。最起码呢，它这个荒滩呢，它能改良一部分，能变成良田。这个外食流失的这个人口啊，它能劳动力啊，它能回来，最起码呢，它能自己在家安安分分的种植自己的地了。
Zhou Li is now working to introduce saltwater rice across all of northeast China. To that end, he's been inviting potential clients to inspect Lan Guangfu's plot. But this is not the extent of the researchers' vision. They have recognized the enormous potential overseas market for saltwater rice. In 2018, they successfully cultivated rice in the desert outside Dubai, yielding an impressive 7.5 tons per hectare, double the global average.
There is very, very good collaboration with the Chinese institution, research institution. ICBA is one of the institution that has a new collaboration with research institution in China. They are trying to find new hybrid species, a new solution for better production, better tolerance. So it can be one of the solution.
While it's had some initial success, saltwater rice is still at the experimental stage. More time is needed before it features regularly on our dining tables.
水稻或那个复杂作物的品种哈，你要在大面积推广，有一个农业部有一个规定，就是你非要审定拿到证书以后，你才能推广，你才卖给老百姓。这我们目前来说是第三年，估计明年就会通过审定拿到这个证书就会推广了。
The Qingdao R&D Center is also experimenting with products that can be made from saltwater rice, such as vinegar and liquor. They hope this will attract further attention and afford them a bigger, more versatile development platform.
So, now we're doing the work. How is it? Is that we're introducing one thing, is that everyone create a platform, and many industries, many companies, all together do something, make this national seawater industry do something.
Saltwater rice has been successfully planted in all 5 major types of saline-alkali soil found in China. The research center has now entered into partnerships with local governments, research institutes, and private companies nationwide. However, There's still a long way to go before saltwater rice can guarantee China's food security. That's why Yuan Longping, despite being in his 90s, is unrelenting in his efforts to raise rice yields to a new level and turn even more barren land into fertile soil. Farmers like Wei Cuiyu, though, are already experiencing the benefits of his research. She's earning a regular income from tending the Qingdao Center's saltwater rice and is looking forward to one day growing it in her own backyard. As for Lan Guangfu and his family, the prospect of hundreds of hectares of formerly barren land being transformed into healthy rice paddies is making them very happy. Like everyone involved in saltwater rice development, they're looking forward to reaping rich rewards.